I find that a lot of folk leave church because when they give themselves to Christ Jesus, they have this belief, and they are taught by some that when you give your life to Christ, that you become faultless and you will never have a sin again. You'll never fall back into sin again. And whenever they fall back into a fault, sometimes it destroys them. And they run back out of the church, and you don't see them coming to church for a while because they've done a fault. Here's a point. Just because you sin does not mean that God does not love you anymore, nor that he has taken away the salvation or the eternal life that he has given you. God is not an Indian giver. God doesn't save you today, and as soon as you screw up, God goes over there and takes that salvation right back from you. And all we're saying that I'm going to save you now, but if you blow it, if you go back and you do this and you go back and you do that, I'm going to take away my salvation from you. That would make God an Indian giver, and God is not an Indian giver. God knows that you cannot keep yourself saved, and he knows that you're going to be tempted as long as you're alive here until he takes the devil out. That's a whole other message. So he knows that you're going to be tempted. He knows that you're going to fall from time to time. But God never takes away eternal life from you. No, he doesn't do that. That would be condemnation. He should declare you unfit from the moment you do something crazy and say, well, you can't make it into eternal life now because you have fallen. It seems to me that that would contradict his word in chapter 3, verse 17. The Lord says, I didn't come to condemn the world, but that the world through me could be saved. So that if you fall into a fault and then he comes back and say, hey, you're not fit, it simply means that I saved you knowing that you would not be able to maintain your salvation. But as soon as you screw up, then I'm going to take salvation away from you and I'm going to castigate you out into hell. What kind of God would he be? Let me just ask you this. Maybe y'all can identify with this. Anybody got children in here? Anybody have a child in here that you spanked his butt because he did something wrong and that child went back and did the same thing? Come on, don't fool me now. Am I right? All right. Now let me ask the good parents this. Did you tell your child, if you go back and do that one more time, I'm going to throw you out of this house and you will no longer be a part of this family. But get out of here and get... Well, I know some of you probably don't say that. But now if that happens, has anybody ever done that? Of course not. Has anybody ever felt like doing it? Don't say it. Look, if we who are earthly parents know how to do good to our own kids, what about your heavenly father? Don't you think that if your child is disobedient, you can punish that child, but you don't put that child out of the family? If you can feel that same type of love for your kid, what about the love that God has for us? Can I get a good witness in here? Isn't it good to know that we have a father that loves us in spite of the things that we do or in spite of the wrong that we've done? So many times, so many come to Christ and then they come genuinely to Christ, but then they run away from the Lord or they run away from church because they've done something that they think that God no longer will tolerate and he won't let them be a part of the family. So he just spikes their butt and he runs them off. You know what that's really called? That's really called deception. You know who does that? John chapter 10 verse 10 says that the thief of life comes but to steal, kill, and to destroy your relationship with God the Father. Anytime you do something crazy, here comes something speaking into your mind, and it tells you, see there, I told you couldn't live holy. I told you that you were going to go back to the same mess that you came to church for. I told you that you were not delivered, you never knew God. As soon as you fall back into a fault, here comes the mess preaching into your mind saying, look at you. And then next thing you know, you get tired of coming back. You stay back out into the world. You've been out there so long that you just decide to slide back. Why? Because what you're doing now, it's like a guilt trip comes on you. You start feeling bad about what you've done. You're guilty about having smoked pot. You're guilty about having had sex with that person that you put out of the house. You feel guilty about the wrong that you're doing. And so because of that guilt, you stop coming to church. If anybody says anything to you, you feel like you're compelled to tell a lie. Oh, no, I don't do that. I've never done that. Why? Because of the judgment that seems like it is upon you. But it is not of God. Say it with me. It is not of God. Say it like you mean it. It is not. God doesn't condemn you because you did wrong.